What's up, everyone? Welcome to another episode of Spitting Venom, aka the Venom Vlog, and we are here today with another Marvel Legends Venom series review of Scream, Marvel's Scream, as they call her. And her real name is Donna Diego. There's a lot of speculation that she's in the movie. Michelle Lee is listed on IMDb as playing as the character in the movie, or playing the Donna Diego character, but we saw her in the trailer as like a medic, which I don't know, they didn't give a backstory really on Donna Diego in the comics too much, so for all I know she could have been a medic, but that's just the version they're going to go with in the movie. And it does look like Michelle Lee is going to have a symbiote, whether it's Riot jumping bodies or if she gets her own and becomes Scream. We do not know as of the recording of this video, so it'll be really interesting to see if she ends up in the film, because she is a fan favorite, that's for sure. And you got some great artwork on the side here, and you got this great art on the back, and again showing you how to build the super big figure of Monster Venom, a former security guard. Okay, so I was wrong, she was a security guard. I thought she worked for Life Foundation, but yeah, so here we go. Former security guard Donna Diego is merged with components of the Venom symbiote and becomes the tendril villain Scream. All right, so there's more artwork and the figure in full. And we have the Monster Venom arm that comes with her. So without further ado, let's crack her open and let's check this figure out. All right, I'm not even going to lie. I'm very scared to even touch this figure or demonstrate her too much because she is hard to balance. It took me a few minutes to get her balanced for this episode, and even still, it's not perfect. You can see the back of her foot, her heel is not even touching the ground there. I had to come up with some creative poses to try to get her to stand because the weight of the hair is just too much. It pulls her back big time. So you have to kind of put more weight in her front, have her arms up like this to kind of balance her out to help out a little bit. So it's not impossible to do, it just takes a little bit of work. And I hope that she stays like this over time, because again, like my Black Cat figure, she'll fall over sometimes because of the weight of like her hair and other things. So it's, you know, I'm hoping this doesn't have that problem. I hope I can find a good position to put her in where she still looks kind of scary and creepy. And she does. I mean, her face is awesome, solid black with the white on there, but she's got the gold and the red coming off her top of her head there, making the hair in the back. She's got some tendrils coming out of the hair, and then she's basically got Carnage's hands repainted. And I don't know what body mold this is, but I feel like this is a pretty standard one that Hasbro uses a lot. And of course she has all of the same joints that all the other figures have: elbow, ball joint on the shoulder. The hand does rotate, but then it also can twist a little bit there. Then she also has the waist, but again, just like Typhoid Mary, it's only in the top part of her torso. So she doesn't have anything here, and she doesn't have a waist swivel. And I'm guessing the reason they did that is because of the hair, because it'll probably tilt her back too much. So they're trying to control what positions you put her in, because obviously too much weight, it'll just make her fall over all the time. So that's a little bit of a bummer, but I will say it is accurate. I mean, the character looks fantastic. The figure overall looks fantastic. So it's something, it's a minor nitpick as far as I'm concerned, because I'll find some way to get her to stand upright, hopefully. But then again, in the legs, you have the swivel at the top of the leg there in the thigh. You have the ball joint up there in the upper leg. You have the knee joints in the two places as usual, and we'll demonstrate that there, just like that. Then she also has an ankle joint, but no thigh swivel, just like Typhoid Mary. I don't know why they do that. I think sometimes with the girl characters, they try to balance it out. They try to give you limited ways to pose them, and it works on some level, because I know sometimes they have characters that have long hair, for example, and they need to, you know, counterbalance that and stuff. But for me, I would still like the option of other stuff. And I would actually wouldn't have minded if some of this hair extensions could have come off and you could have added stuff on. So that way you could customize it the way you want to, and you can make her hair as wild as you want, or have some of the tendrils be bendable and you can pull them forward and kind of counterbalance her that way too. Either one of those would have been a great option. I'm sure it probably is not feasible from a financial standpoint, but I would have liked to have those extra pieces. So I'm going to hold her there. Hopefully she stands upright long enough for me to show you the arm that she comes with for Monster Venom. So there's Monster Venom's arm. He's got some of the spider design coming over on the biceps there. So yeah, looks pretty cool. Overall, I think the monster figure is going to look great. I can't wait to see what he looks like, so we'll get to that in a future video very, very soon. But for now, this is Scream. What do you guys think of her? I think she looks awesome. Donna Diego is such a neat character. A lot of you probably know her from not just the Lethal Protector comics, but if you've ever been to Universal Studios in Florida when they have the Spider-Man ride, I don't know if that ride's still around or not. I hope it is, because it's a great ride. But on it, you actually have Scream jump on the hood of the car and slash at you in 3D, which is pretty cool. And it was neat to see that character transcend the pages and get that kind of treatment in a, you know, roller coaster, no less. So let me know what you guys think of this figure down below. Again, these figures are $22.99 roughly and you can pick them up at any store, as long as it's a GameStop, Target, Walmart. You can buy them on Amazon. And I would say, you know, try not to spend more than 30 or 40 bucks if you have to have the character, but if you can get it for the retail price of $22.99, it's definitely worth it. Thanks for watching my video. As always, like, share, subscribe, all that fun stuff, and we'll see you in the future. Peace.